So in terms of storage, RDBMS are designed, are classified into different categories, like how they store data. There is key value store database. There is document-oriented database. And there is a wide column family database. There are graph databases. So there are lots of different categories of databases in terms of storage. Let us try to see what are the key features of these different types of databases. In key value database, there is a key and then there is a value. A key is something on the basis of which you do the lookup. Like you can, for analogy, you can compare the key to be the primary key of RDBMS. So there is a key and it has got some value associated with it. Key can be anything. It could be integer, a string, any key which is supported. Anything which can be converted into bytes. And value can contain different fields. For example, you can have ID as the key and you can have name and age as the value. So these can be the value and this is the key. It can be possible in this way. So the lookup on the basis of key becomes very, very fast. If you have to search for a particular key and obtain the corresponding value, insertion, deletion, updation, or any other activity you might want to perform, it is very, very fast. In document-oriented database, and the example of key value database is HBase. There is a key and there is a value. HBase is key value type and it is also wide column family type. So what happens in wide column family type is all columns are collected together in a column family. So you collect columns together in a column family and all the data of a column family is stored together. So you can have a column family, say personal details, and you can have a column family as professional details. So inside, these are the column families. So they will contain lots of columns inside that. A personal column family may contain fields like name. It can contain like location. It can contain age. So all the columns which are used together, they are stored together in a column family. And professional column family may contain experience. It may contain visa details. It may contain a skill set of the employee. So these things can be considered as a professional detail of an employee. And you can have a key as well. So key can be the employee ID because every employee is having a different employee ID. So HBase is both. HBase is key value type and it is wide column family type database as well. So again, this is like how data is stored. The classification goes on that level. If you talk about document-oriented database, they contain documents. And one document is like one column of, or sorry, one record of an RDBMS. To give you an idea, if in RDBMS we have got something like this, there is ID, there is name, there is age, for example. So ID is 1, name is A, age is 10, ID is 2, name is B, age is 20. So there are two records. In a document-oriented database, they will be stored as a document, like ID, it is 1. Name is a string, so it can be A. Age, so age can be 10. So this is one document, what we call this as a document. So it corresponds to one row of an RDBMS. So this is a document. And a collection of document is a table, and you can easily see these are the different fields of the particular document. So these are the fields. Again, they have dynamic schema. And a collection of document is analogous to a table, which is called as collection. So we call them as a collection. So a different document can have like this. It can have ID as XYZ. You can see here the ID is integer, here the ID is a string. So different documents can have different schema, that's perfectly fine. And it can have location as a column or location as a field, and location can be an array as well, like in terms of latitude and longitude. So you can see it's completely dynamic. The name and age are not here. So different documents can have, this is document one and this is document two. So different documents can have different fields, different types of fields as well. So this is also one type of databases which fall under the category of document oriented. So they contain documents and collections. And they also contain, collections are like tables, documents are like rows, and they also contain databases. So inside a database, you can create multiple collections. One example of document-based database is MongoDB, which is a very popular document-based database, document-oriented database. And many times we require graph processing. Like graph processing may look like, suppose if you talk about any Facebook post, so there is a post and there is a user U1 who has created the post. So it creates the post, and in the post, two users were tagged. You know, you can tag some persons in the post. So in this particular post, the post name is P1 tagged. So these are the two users who have been tagged in the post. Going forward, there could be like, say, user U4 who has commented on the post. He comments on the post. And there could be something like there is some user U5 who likes the post. And there could be multiple user who likes the post. So you see, the conclusion is you can have a lot more features. There is a lot more relationship. In RDBMS, these relationships can be represented in the form of different tables. And suppose I want to answer a question. My question is, what are the posts of user 1 which were liked by at least one user and commented by at least two users? It could be like that, or you can go ahead and add more features and tagged at least three users. So you see, this is our one question which I would like to answer. So if you want to answer these kinds of questions, so since there are lots of relationships, you have to make lots of different joins in the RDBMS, because I have to go for the post of U1, which were liked by some, which were commented by some, and those posts tagged some users. In order to have these things in place, we don't want to join always. So graph databases are a very good fit for handling these kinds of situations. But again, if there is not much of a relationship, graph databases are an overkill, because inserting into the graph databases take a little longer time. Retrieval takes quite less time. So the examples of graph database is Neo4j. It's the most famous graph database, or you can talk about TitanDB as well. So these are some examples of NoSQL databases which are graph databases. So they are meant for handling graph structures. And graphs are a very important data structure. There are lots of algorithms on graphs, like connected components, shortest path, minimum spanning tree, Disk-Strauss algorithm, Kruskal's algorithm, Prim's algorithm. So it has got its own domain, which is also exciting. And having this idea in mind, so we have now covered what are the different types of databases. So the graph databases are very good if you want to manage relationships, and there are lots of them, so you can avoid joins. Okay, so if you talk about wide column, one more example is there Cassandra, which is also very famous NoSQL database. So these are the different categories of NoSQL databases in terms of storage, like how they store data.
Acadgild. Average is dead.